Assalamu alaikum dear students, welcome back into a new lecture 58. This is class first year and I am your teacher Adnan Ali. My dear students, in previous lectures we just got finished chapter 10, Forms and Functions in Plants, in which we studied different concepts about the plants. We studied growth in plants. We also studied that how water uptake occur in opening and closing of the stomata. We discussed many topics. We discussed in our previous chapter, which were all about the forms and functions of the plant. In the last lecture, we discussed about vernalization, which is a low temperature treatment to induce the process of flowering in some biennial plants. Dear students, today I am here to deliver my lecture on a new topic, and we are starting today a new chapter, chapter 11, and the title of the chapter is Digestion. It is not a new phenomena for my students know very well that what is actually digestion. But in first year level, it is a bit explained, but the foundation will be the same as you studied in the class 9. So let's start our today's lecture. First of all, we need to define digestion. And what is digestion? So digestion is a process by which complex food molecules are broken into simple absorbable process in the every organism, in every animal, it's in a vital process, because if there is no digestion, how the food will come into the body, and if the food is not coming, what we will oxidize to get the energy, and if there is no energy, how the work will be done, how different organs will work. So definitely it's a vital process, and organisms can't survive without this vital process. Now there are two types of digestion. One is called mechanical, and second one is called chemical. In mechanical digestion, there is cutting, grinding, of food, churning. These are the mechanical processes. Usually the teeth, with the help of saliva, they mechanically break the large food particles into the small one. But none of the chemistry is involved, and none of the chemical reaction is involved in. The next is the chemical digestion. process involved, but the action of enzymes are involved. For example, carbohydrates, starch will be digested by the action of by the amylase enzyme. So these foods, amylase will break down the bonds between the starch monomers, and they will break them down into the simple molecules which will be absorbable. And if they are absorbed by our bodies, they will be easily oxidized. So without chemical digestion, digestion is not done. Both type of the digestions in the humans will run parallel. We can't say that this is less important, this is more important, and this is less important, and this is more important. No, both are facilitating each other in the human digestive system. Now let's start the human digestive system. Which is called as elementary amoeba. Which is also part of the GI tract, gastro, intestine, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine. So it means that it will start from the oral cavity and will end on the last part of the large intestine. So these are the components of the elementary canal. Now we will start each and every component we will take and we will explain them. So let's start. Cavity, which start from the mouth, this cavity is called as oral cavity. Now, what structures are included in the oral cavity? First is tongue. Taste and movement of food in the this is called as this is the tongue. The tongue have some structures which are called as papilla. These papilla consist of the taste buds, which are not only responsible for the detection of the taste, but also make this structure, rough appearance. Rough appearance they will give it. That's why the food will stay and will slowly move inside the oral cavity. Now the palate. Which found the two boundaries of the oral cavity. From the roof of the cavity. And it has two, it consists of two parts, hard palate and soft palate. The interior part of this, the hard palate, and the posterior, the soft.
The next part is the teeth. Usually in class making, you have two sets of teeth, and in humans also. First is called as the milk teeth, which usually shed at the age of 6 years, and then permanent teeth. The permanent teeth are 32, and these 32 teeth can be divided into four different types: incisors, front teeth, canine, the pointed side teeth, premolar, and molar. These are the four types of teeth. These two types of teeth are usually responsible for the grinding of the food. These two types are for the cutting and tearing process. The general structure of the teeth is that it has two parts, the crown, salivary glands, usually secrete saliva. And the saliva consists of an enzyme called amylase enzyme. And it has the mucus also, which are responsible for the softening of the food. The saliva is secreted by three glands, carotids, submandibular, and sublingual. So, ideal structure, my dear students, these are all the structures which are present in the oral cavity. Now, this was the structure of the oral cavity. Now, next, we are going to explain the function of the oral cavity. Function of the oral cavity. Dear students, the oral cavity is a unique place where two types of digestion occur. Mechanical digestion also occur and chemical digestion also occur. First is mechanical digestion. Mechanical digestion will include cutting, tearing, grinding. And teeth are mainly responsible. Along with that, tongue is responsible for the movement of food inside the oral cavity. And the mastication process occur here. Food is softened by the adding saliva. So these are all mechanical processes. Mechanical digestion. I told you that from ideas. So it is thought that 2 to 3% of the total carbohydrates will be digested inside the oral cavity. So dear students, what we learn? We learn that the digestion process starts from the oral cavity, and not only mechanical digestion, the main part of the mechanical digestion will occur inside the oral cavity, but the chemical digestion will also start here, and 3 to 5% of the carbohydrate will be digested here. But what type of molecules which were not digested here or which will not be digested in the oral cavity? That will be protein, that will be lipids. They are never digested inside the oral cavity. But the only thing that will be digested are the starch. The starch should be converted to glucose. I told you that if you grind the food and you chew the food too much, after some time, it will give you the taste, a sweet taste will start. This is the action of the thiamine or the bilase enzyme or the starch, which will convert them into glucose and the monosaccharides. So this was all about the oral cavity and the functions of the oral cavity. Now we are moving towards the pharynx. Next is the pharynx. Pharynx, it is a short muscular chamber. And it is not only the part of the digestive system but also the part of the respiratory system. So three parts it have usually. One is called nasopharynx. Third one is laryngeopharynx. The nasopharynx usually communicates another cavity with the breathing system. Oropharynx, it is behind the soft palate into nasopharynx. Its function is a passageway for moving food. It is the passageway for moving food. In the last part of the laryngeopharynx, it opens it to the larynx and esophagus. Larynx and esophagus. So the main function of the pharynx is the process of swallowing. What will occur in the swallowing process? The tongue, as I told you, its responsibility is to move the food inside the oral cavity. Due to this movement, the food will turn into a bile-like structure which is called as a bolus. This bolus will move towards the oral pharynx. Now the oral pharynx when they will reach to the old fangs, the soil will reflexes by the fang soil will start, which are involuntary, and the lens, which is called as the wise box, it will rise up to meet the epiglottis. Epiglottis is the covering above the glottis, and in that way the food will move above the trachea without a trip into the nasal cavity. Because I told you that fats is not only the part of the digestive system, it is also part of the respiratory system. So there by DHRs, then the food particles should enter into the respiratory process, which will create a trouble. So that's why we need a preventive mechanism, and this preventive mechanism is very well established by the pharynx. So this was all about the pharynx. Inshallah, next we will start the esophagus, peristalsis, stomach, small intestine, and large intestine. Hope that you people got good understanding. Thank you so much. Stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.